Let's take a look at creating datum feature symbols as part of geometric dimensioning and tolerancing in model-based definition. And this video pertains to Creo Parametric 4.0 and later. The first thing that I'm going to do is click on the Annotate tab to create a new combination state for my datums. And if I take a look at the bottom of the screen, I have my combination state. It gets a default name. I'm going to right-click on it and choose Rename and just call it Datums. And you might have a different name. You might already have a combination state in your model templates for them. If you don't see your combination states down at the bottom of the screen, you can use the Configuration option, File Options Configuration Editor, and set Displayed Combined Views to Yes. Also, if you go to your View Manager on the All tab, you should be able to turn on the display of combined views as well. So now that I have my datum set up, I'm going to make sure I'm using the correct annotation plane for the first one. And my first one, my A reference, is going to be this back surface of the model that's going to be used for mounting. And nope, I don't want to use front. Nope, top isn't right. Actually, that looks pretty good. The right view looks how I want my first annotation to appear. And if you don't have the one that you want, you can click on this little down arrow and create a new annotation plane that reflects the way that you want the annotation to be viewed and oriented in the model. But again, I'm happy with right for displaying it. And before I create my datum feature symbol, I'm going to create a geometric tolerance for the flatness of this surface. So I'll click on geometric tolerance and move my mouse till the surface highlights, then position where I want the geometric tolerance to appear and middle mouse click. In the dashboard, this is the setup for the geometric tolerance, but this isn't going to be for position. The first one is going to be for flatness. And it's using a pretty big value right now. Let's change that. So I've got my qualifying geometric tolerance. I will just left click on the background of the screen in order to deselect it and close the dashboard. Now I'm going to create the datum feature symbol that's going to be attached to this. So click datum feature symbol, and I'm just going to move my mouse until the geometric tolerance highlights. You can see that I can reposition the plunger either on the top or the bottom. I want it to be on the bottom. And when I have it positioned where I want, middle mouse click, and it is automatically giving it the letter A. We have a dashboard for the datum feature. If I go to references, I can make sure that this surface is selected so that that is the semantic reference if I'm exporting this in step AP242. And any coordinate measuring machines that I use later on for inspection will know that this is the related surface. That's good. I will click OK. There we can see the label, additional text. You can change the shape of the elbow if you want. And then options over here. I like this designate button here. If you're using NPM link, you can use this as part of driving control characteristics and other information into Windchill. So that is good for my datum reference A. For my next reference, I'm going to use the bottom surfaces here that is going to be placed on for mounting. And again, for this one, I'm going to use my create my qualifying geometric tolerance first. So let's click on geometric tolerance, and I'm going to pick on, make sure I get this surface to highlight, and then, oops, I don't think I got it. There we go. And then middle mouse click. And right now it is again giving me flatness like I had before. Let's go to the drop-down list. I'm going to choose perpendicularity, and it's saying, hey, there's this red slash over here, which is a warning that a datum reference is required. So I'm going to click in here to set my primary reference, and actually I can use this icon to the right to select an existing reference and then click OK. And the red slash goes away. Everything is good for that tolerance. You'll notice that the symbol is green in here, indicating that all is good in my world. So let's left click to deselect. And for this one, actually, let's go back, click on it again. For the references, it just has one surface highlighted over there. If I hold down the control key, I can select the other surface that pertains to the mounting. And just like before, when I create my A datum feature symbol, let's create our B datum feature symbol. And again, I will just select the geometric tolerance and then drag down over here. And for the references for this one, let's select the two surfaces that are relevant. Click OK. And there we have our B datum. And for my C datum, I want it to be a midplane between these two different surfaces. So I'm going to use Show Annotations to figure out which dimension that is. Let's select the main protrusion. And I want the 621 dimension. So I've selected it and it is checked in this list over here. That's the only one I'm going to make visible at this time. Let's grab this and drag it and allow it to snap to being in the middle. And again, for this one, I could create a geometric tolerance and attach it to that. And we'll leave the perpendicularity perpendicular with respect to A. For the references, select the relevant side surfaces for defining the midplane. And create a datum feature symbol. Attach it to the geometric tolerance. Middle mouse click when I have it positioned. There we have our C datum tag in here. And let's go to references and select the relevant surfaces that it should use to define it. And again, selecting these surfaces is important for semantic query. If I select the surfaces, I want the relevant geometric tolerances and datum feature symbols to highlight. If I select a datum feature symbol or geometric tolerance, I want those surfaces to highlight. And I also want that information driven downstream to any manufacturing processes and inspection processes. So I've got my A, B, and C datums. I'm going to expand GP1 over here, geometric tolerance one over here, and I have a datum reference feature. I can right click on it and define the relevant coordinate system. And so coordinate system should be the intersection of this surface and this surface. And oops, I hope I have a midplane. There we go. And select this surface over here. And then I can control the orientation. And I want this surface, maybe I want this surface to define Z. Let's flip that. And I want that surface to define Y. Let's flip that. Yeah, this is how I want my X, Y, and Z to be oriented for my coordinate system. Let's click OK. And turn off my datum plane display. So let's go to this pinion housing part. And again, I will start off by going to the annotate tab, creating a new combination state. And let's right click on it to rename it. And I'm going to call it datums. Let's go to datum geometric tolerance, pick the surface, and then middle mouse click. And again, for this one, we're going to qualify it with flatness. I'm going to leave the default value in there. Then we will create our datum feature symbol, attach it on over here, middle mouse click, automatically gets to be named A. And for references, let's select that surface for the appropriate reference. Click OK for that one. Now for the next one, next important thing is going to be the mounting through this cylindrical surface. So let's show annotations, pick the surface, and I like that dimension, click OK. And I'm gonna click on it in order to reposition it. And the way it's being displayed is sort of like in the model right now. I'm gonna right click on it and choose move to plane and move it to this surface over here, just so it's a little easier to see and not blocked by any geometry. Next step for that particular dimension, I'm going to create a geometric tolerance and attach it to the dimension. And this one is again going to be for perpendicularity and needs to know what reference I want to use. So let's pick the A reference. And I'm going to leave the value that it has in there. For the references, let me select the cylindrical surface, left click on the background of the screen, and for my datum feature symbol, select the geometric tolerance, drag down to where I want it to appear, and middle mouse click, and there we have B. References, let's select the cylindrical surface, and there we have our next geometric tolerance and dimension and datum feature symbol. Again, we can go to our datum reference frame. I'm going to turn on my axis display, and for this datum reference frame, I can right click and define a coordinate system. Let's pick this surface over here, control and pick my center axis, and for orientation, let's say I want that surface to define Z. Clicking the other collector and use, I'm going to use this flat surface to define X. There we go. That's how I want it oriented. On the properties tab, we can display the coordinate system name, and you can make the display zoom dependent. I don't like that option, but let's click OK. And there we have our datum reference frame. Similarly, for this part, I could go on and define maybe a C datum for this bottom surface for mounting and any other references that I want for my datum feature symbols. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you liked this video or learned anything, please give it a thumbs up, write a comment, and click the subscribe button to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.